It takes a lot of juggling to meet current demands for electricity. Older smoke-spewing power plants manipulate coal and petrol. Modern plants juggle with a combination of steam boilers and fast-responding gas turbines to meet the fluctuating needs of consumers. But they too pollute the atmosphere. No wonder that researchers increasingly look to the sun for a solution. A major step towards this goal was achieved recently at the Weizmann Institute's Solar Research Complex, one of three such facilities in the world, and the only one located on the grounds of a major research institute. The process of harnessing solar energy for electricity invariably begins with a system that collects concentrated sunlight in order to heat air, which in turn drives a turbine to generate electricity. A major obstacle to solar power has been the inability of existing solar receivers to operate at the high temperatures and pressures demanded by modern equipment. Weizmann experts have now broken this barrier with a series of record-breaking improvements. Their new system features a uniquely designed funnel-shaped concentrator that magnifies and concentrates the sunlight to the extreme temperatures that today's turbines require. The system's technological breakthrough lies in the receiver, where hundreds of light-absorbing ceramic pins line the inner walls. These porcupine-like ceramic fingers provide a large surface area for maximum absorption of sunlight, while preventing the cracks that might result from extreme changes in temperature. Their unique design allows the air to flow through rapidly, removing heat 10 times faster than existing equipment. With the new concentrator and ceramic receiver in place, the system is ready for a test drive. Sunlight is beamed up from the array of mirrors directly into the funnel, where it is further concentrated to 10,000 times the intensity of natural sunlight. The temperature inside the receiver rises to over 1,200 degrees Celsius, well above the 700 degrees required for turbine operation. To drastically reduce costs, the Weizmann scientists had the bright idea of placing a reflecting mirror on top of a simple structure and beaming the concentrated rays down. This way, the heavy receiver and generator can be built on ground level rather than in huge, expensive towers. The next step is a 300-kilowatt pilot plant soon to be built at the Weizmann Institute solar facility by a consortium of Israeli companies working together with America's leading turbine manufacturers. The ultimate goal, solar stations throughout the world, providing pollution-free power at a competitive price. A bright future, now one big step closer.